So the first award tonight goes to Greg Summerhays. Greg Summerhays. Greg was nominated by Carlos Baez and Sylvia Norman. Greg has always been a promoter and advocate for diversity. I got to know Greg when he was at the United Way of Salt Lake. He is truly a leader, a mentor, and a friend who cares deeply for our community. Greg, in addition to his busy job with the Sandy Chamber of Commerce, he also volunteers countless hours helping community organizations to better assist and understand our diverse community. His confidence and appreciation for our diverse communities has been a pillar in creating new leadership to help our community to become a place where everyone is included and where everyone has a voice. Greg. She's telling him he's not off yet. He has to sit there for a minute. So the next award goes to Sarah Ortiz, nominated by Eric D. Packenham and Malia D. Balls. Sarah fights against discrimination and has used various media platforms to convey the importance of equality. She created a video, an essay regarding race relations, both of which won the Utah State Office of Education's Martin Luther King Jr. contest. Sarah also works to educate the community with the hopes that race relations improve through video, essay, and a website. By raising awareness, Sarah hopes that the community is influenced to become a more positive space. Sarah. Final award tonight goes to Jerry Leonard. Jerry was nominated by Vicky Johansson and Dwight Rasmussen, two incredible Salt Lake County employees, I might add, who also deserve an award, but they're not giving you one tonight. I know them personally, they're great people. Jerry provides rides to medical appointments 2 days per week and delivers meals to homebound older people at least once per week. He has also stepped up to volunteer to assist with a project that teaches seniors how to use public transit to go to the grocery store. Through his volunteer service, Jerry is enhancing the quality of life, fostering a greater sense of dignity, and helping the people that he serves to fulfill their desire to remain independent. I always say as mayor, one of the best parts of the job of being mayor is I get to see, meet people like Jerry and the work that they're doing in their community. And so Vicky and Dwight, also thank you for noticing. Isn't it great to see people like that who are in our community, and we as Salt Lake County just get to see the goodness in this community. So thank you for noticing, and thank you all. So thank you, Greg, Sarah, and Jerry, for your excellent work in our community. Please join me in giving this year's local heroes a round of applause. And with that, that's all from me. So thank you to everyone, and enjoy your evening, and I hope there's... Well, thank you, Emma. Let me welcome you all today to what is one of my favorite events that we do every year, is the Diversity Dinner. So it's great to meet some new people who are here tonight, and some people who have been here before, who are here for this great event. I'm really so proud of our community's effort to acknowledge and celebrate diversity in our community and recognize really how diversity strengthens us. So I want to thank, first of all, Salt Lake County Director of Diversity and Inclusion, Ms. Emma Houston. Thank you. She has really hit the ground running, and I didn't think it would be possible to fill the shoes of Rebecca Sanchez, but Emma Houston is doing an incredible job. We're so lucky to have her at the county. I also want to thank the members of the Council on Diversity Affairs, or CODA, for putting this event together tonight. Thank you, CODA members. Can you raise your hands? They're here. They're not raising their hands high enough, but they do such incredible work. Thank you for putting together the event tonight. And not only the event tonight, but I'm also so grateful for your tireless work promoting diversity and inclusion throughout our entire county. You know, we're all different in so many different ways, but we're also the same. We value the respect and understanding and positive community that comes with sitting down together and sharing a meal and ideas with each other. And that's what tonight's about. It's also an important time to not only recognize how we're all a little bit the same, but it's also to celebrate how we are all a little bit different. Earlier this year, like many of you, I'm sure, was horrified to watch the events in Charlottesville, Virginia. In real time, we saw the things that were previously reserved for the history books that I remember reading about and being appalled with going through school, and yet we see this in our community today. And it reminds us how close we are and how racism and hatred is not that deep beneath the surface. It was really a sad sight, and a sight that has no place in our country. While I was, and I still am, angry about what happened in Charlottesville, it was also comforting to see so many people stand up against it and to remember that there is love in this community and unity in this community, that the best of us and the best among us still exist. And that was inspiring as well. So let's clap for that too. I'm gonna tell you a story since I see Naima here. Julie and I took a vacation earlier this year, and we went to Europe, and we were returning from our vacation, and we had a layover in London. It was really just a few hours in London, but Julie commented how interesting it and how diverse London was, and how from everywhere, you know, we flew into one airport and flew out of the other, so it was really kind of just transiting through. I've been before, but just how everywhere London is such a diverse and multicultural society, and how refreshing that was. And then we got on a plane and we flew home to Salt Lake City. We walked into the Salt Lake City airport, and she was commenting, and she made this comment as we were walking off the airplane, and then she said, "Look how diverse Salt Lake City is." And we walked off the airplane and saw Naima and some of her friends and family who were welcoming family home from Mecca. And we looked at, you know, we saw the families who were welcoming their missionaries home, but also families who were welcoming their loved ones home from a similar religious experience. And we've come a long way in Salt Lake, in the Salt Lake Valley. It was so exciting to see that. And I was so pleased that it was a familiar face as well, that we saw people we knew there. I was embarrassed a little bit because I'd just been on a 16-hour flight and didn't look like a mayor. So I was a little embarrassed to be walking off of this. So embarrassed to see people I knew, but happy to see people I knew. So we live in a great place. We are a quickly diversifying community, one that embraces our diversity, where people are loved and cherished for who they are, and the differences that make them different and the sameness that makes them same is loved and cherished. I recognize that we have our challenges even here in Salt Lake City, but what a great community we live in. And our diversity has made us stronger, and we are increasingly a diverse community. And it was great to see that and walk off an airplane and recognize that that our reputation is very different than our reality. And our reality is one that I love. I love living in this community. It's a wonderful community. So tonight is about recognizing that diversity really is about all of us. We all come from different backgrounds with unique experiences. We all bring something of value to the table. I don't know how many of you have participated in Emma's diversity training. And if you have, you know that her training